Finally, a Reebok Retro. Yo, what's good, guys? This is Nightwing2303 from WearTesters.com. Today we got a quick detailed look and review of these bad boys right here. This is the Reebok Aztrek, brought back straight from the 90s, and they look almost identical to the originals. It's crazy. As some of you guys, longtime viewers might know, I'm a huge fan of Reebok products, most notably the Reebok basketball line, especially the Iverson stuff, both the Question, which is one of my favorite shoes of all time, as well as the Answer series. Now, these guys here are not a basketball shoe, it's a runner, and like I said before, it is back and straight from the 90s. I just think that these things look fantastic. And the funny thing is that while you might have been made fun of for wearing something like this a few years ago, now these things are actually popular because they're dad shoes or whatever. So it's kind of weird how things just like move in circles. You know what I mean? Like what comes around goes around in quite a literal sense. Now back in the 90s, this was a versatile runner, according to Reebok at least. So this was something that you could run on any type of surface. So this is kind of like a trail run shoe, but also a pavement shoe or a treadmill shoe. It really didn't matter. The shoe itself was built for all terrain, basically. You have a nice, thick, durable outsole, both on the original and on this retro. You've got Reebok's Hexalite, which is bottom-loaded right there in the heel. Nothing in the forefoot. Instead, the midsole itself is made out of a compression-molded EVA. The upper is very traditional for what we used to get back in the 90s, which is a straight-up nylon upper. So back then, the nylon was kind of like today's mesh, so it was something that was breathable, lightweight, flexible, fairly durable, required very little break-in time and all that kind of good stuff. So nylon is back, and then on top of the nylon there are multiple overlays, which I think is awesome. This is what I love the most about 90s shoes in general. Not just 90s shoes, but shoes before the whole like knitted age, is that these shoes actually had layers to them. They had substance, they had style, they had build, they had a real design to them. They weren't just a shape knitted and constructed and plopped on top of a midsole. Somebody actually thought real hard about these things and was just like, no, I'm gonna place this looking panel on this portion of the shoe. It's gonna be for this purpose, whether it be for lateral containment, durability, and all that kind of stuff. And that's what I just really like about older models. And it's something that we're missing, I feel, in today's era. Like I like knits and stuff like that. I think that they're great when they work, but nothing beats this type of build or construction. Something with just depth, you know what I mean? Like you look at this and you're like, man, that's a pretty shoe. The overlays themselves are comprised of what feels like felt. So it's like a synthetic suede or a nubuck. Kind of weird that it's white felt because that's going to get dirty real quick. But while they're clean, they look really clean. Obviously, that was stupid. Now, this colorway is an original colorway. Again, just brought back straight from the 90s. There's another original colorway available right now as well. Those ones are actually really, really clean. I couldn't decide which one I wanted more. Grabbed these ones. Got my computer over here, and while I'm looking at them, I'm like, man, I kinda wanted the other one too. They're a nice off-white look with some hot pink hits, as well as a navy blue nylon build. Just a really clean shoe. Screams 90s. I just love it. These scream 90s too. The teal, the white, the black, all that stuff. I mean, this is just like, give me some MC Hammer pants that are made out of this same color with multicolored splatter paint all over it. Yes, I used to have a pair. They were awesome. Rock them with these guys, and man, you're just, I mean, you're straight up like a blast from the past, man. Talk about time traveling. Now, as far as overall fit, they do fit true to size. So if you were interested in these guys, that's exactly what I would recommend. And that's pretty much it. I mean, I don't have much else to say. They're available now, great price point. They start around $90. And then more colorways are gonna be coming soon. So if you're not feeling these or the other original colorway, there's an archive that Reebok's actually starting to dig through. So it's gonna be interesting to see which colorways they pull from or if we're gonna get like brand new looks. I'd prefer for them to stick with the OG stuff because again, like I feel like this stuff has now come back around. So I think that this is just perfect for today's like trends, even though this is just what we call back in the 90s. Style. Thank you so much for watching. Thanks for your support. Let us know what you think about the Reebok Aztrek down below in the comment section. Did you grab a pair? Are you interested in grabbing a pair? Did you own any Reebok runners back in the day? If so, let us know what they were. Bring back those memories. You know what I'm saying? Like, let's bring back the feels. But thank you guys so much for watching. Thanks for all your support. And until next time, guys, have a good one.